return to Canada, not too far from the home of Bret the Hitman Hart.
Not very far at all. You know, Gorilla, some time ago you told me we had several conversations about this man. I think it was about a year ago you told me you wouldn't be surprised if he ended up the greatest wrestler ever in the WWF with that particular adornment that goes around his waist right now.
Well, Mr. Excellence of Execution was just a matter of time, in my opinion, and this guy had the persistency, Your Lordship, to stick with it through thick and through thin, had all his trials and tribulations, and now has reached the pinnacle of the mountain and sits atop the WWF, and what a flag bearer indeed Bret is for the World Wrestling Federation.
He is indeed, and I really do believe that you have to face adversity to become a champion with a lot of integrity, which this man has. He has faced adversity, he has overcome that, and now he steps into the ring with tremendous confidence, great enthusiasm, and I really want to see what the Berzerker can do against this powerful, powerful wrestling machine, who is, of course, the Hitman Bret Hart.
Well, the Berzerker with that very unorthodox style. This is our feature matchup on this particular edition of Primetime Wrestling. And Mr. Fuji would like nothing better than to get his hands on the gold of the WWF.
Well, he has maneuvered his man, Berzerker, into a most enviable position here. It certainly makes a lot in your career when you do have somebody like Fuji prompting and prodding you forward all the time.
Sometimes he even whacks you with that cane.
Yes, he does.
I've seen him do that.
But I don't think that hurts the Berzerker, do you?
The Berzerker's obviously missing about four bricks short of a full load, Albert. He's not all there.
You mean to say if he built a house, it would fall down?
Oh, absolutely. But a big, powerful, dangerous individual who has the ability to beat anyone on any given evening. That's the Berzerker.
Yes, and he looks bigger than ever to me now. It looks like he's put on about another 15 or 20 pounds to that tremendous 300-pound frame. But just look at Hart going to work on this man.
Well, that's what you do when you're outpowered in there and outsized and outweighed. Oh, look at that leverage move. Handful of hair and a whole lot of hair on the Berzerker. And look, at he comes up swinging. I told you he's not there.
No, neither is Bret Hart, nowhere near him, but he was swinging, you're right.
The lights are on, but believe me, there's nobody home.
No, nobody answer the telephone there. Look at him. Fuji is like now appealing to him, get back in the ring.
You know, but the Hitman, realizing that this is a title match, the title is on the line, you have to be careful.
Yes, you do indeed. And he was caught napping very, very slightly, but not a great deal.
And of course, a lot of things on the mind of the Hitman as he will be facing at Survivor Series, at the Thanksgiving tradition, at the Richfield Coliseum on Thanksgiving Eve, the number one challenger for the coveted WWF title, Shawn Michaels.
And what a match that promises to be. We have seen Shawn Michaels in action. He does look so well. And recently I've had to say this about Shawn Michaels. If anybody can take that belt away from Bret Hart, he is the man to do it. And it can be done.
Oh, it certainly can be done. Incidentally, folks, you won't want to leave us right after this match, because coming up on a special video hookup direct from TSN in Calgary, Alberta, Canada, we're going to have the Hitman right here on Primetime Wrestling. Oh, look at this. Pile driver. Oh, he held him up there a long time.
That was a very, very good delayed pile driver by the Berzerker there. All the blood went down to Bret Hart's head. He was very, very competitive with that particular move, but not with that one.
Boy, he waited too long and telegraphed that move, and the Hitman was waiting. Look at this. Inverted atomic drop. Finds the mark. Flying clothesline, and the big guy goes down. Hitman on a roll.
And superb execution there by Hart.
Neck breaker over for the cover, too. No. Whoa, was that close.
And I think that was just a token covered by the Hitman there, just to show him what can happen to him. He loves doing this, Hart. He teases you, he toys with you, he plays with you, and then he out-wrestles you completely.
Hitman, second turnbuckle on the inside. nice elbow finds the mark right between the eyes of the Berzerker. Oh, he's going for it. We're going to see perhaps the sharpshooter. Can he get it on those humongous legs? Yes! Stick the fork in the Berzerker. He's done. Let's get the official word. What a tremendous victory here for Bret the Hitman Hart, reigning WWF Champion, holds on to the gold. Holy mackerel, this guy's going to be champion for a long, long time in my book. Stay with us, Hitman coming up.